Are we on a rooftop?
Central, Big Sky in position on approach of the abduction site. Strike One is awaiting drop clearance.
Copy that, Big Sky. Strike One is cleared to engage hostile targets.
That is a little bit of a shame. Alright, this map is super spooky and dark. We don't know where all the enemies can be. So we're gonna play it a little bit safe. So, we're gonna try and get my character up on the roof. I think that's possible. But we'll see what happens.
Double time.
We still have one assault back here. Whoops! We will, where could I put you? I could have sent this guy up here. I don't want to trigger a sectoid or anything, but we're gonna have to. Okay, we're fine for now. We're gonna move my assault guy up very slowly, because we don't know where the enemies are going to be. And we're always gonna use our assault or our sniper character last, because we never know if we're gonna trigger something. And if our characters have vision on it, a sniper can shoot them, as long as she actually has like a straight line to them.
I'm on it, Commander.
On the move.
Oops. I think I sent her to the wrong place. Ah, well. Oh boy. We don't know what kind of trouble we're going to be running into on this mission. Yep. Great. They're the Seekers. I hate Seekers. Here they come. So if you don't know what Seekers are, they're basically these guys that go invisible. And then they strangle your guys. Which isn't too bad, as long as you're prepared for it, so we're just gonna saddle up and get ready for it. So unless they go for my sniper, they're gonna be kind of in the middle of every single person, and that'd be bad for them. Oh, there they go! Oh, man.
Taken care of.
Even my sniper got in on that action. Alright, so there's a second one, so we're just gonna kind of stick everybody on Overwatch as well. Until the second one is dead, I'm not moving up. Okay, I was really expecting it to try and attack, so never mind. I rescind my statement, we're moving up. I really want to get on the rooftop, but it doesn't look like there's any access up there, which is a little bit of a shame. The good news is, later on I can get items that can help you get on top of stuff without having a ladder there, but for now, we're just kind of screwed on that regard. We're gonna move up. We're gonna put everybody inside of here. Oh! Thin men! I really would like to blow one of them up, but it doesn't look like I'm close enough, so that's a little bit of a shame.
Moving on target location.
And obviously I'd like to capture them as well, but we're a little bit far away. We'll see what ends up happening. These guys are really out of position though. If the thin men even just go into the train, these guys are fucked. Oh boy.
Cover my flank.
Ooh, that could have been bad. Flanks give you a higher crit chance, and so if that had been a crit, I think my heavy would have just been straight up dead.
X-rays coming in from the sides.
Aw, fuck you. Oh, I'm a thin man. I have a long range 100% hit chance for a fucking poison cloud. Where's my sniper? I'm gonna fuck him up. Or I could capture both of them. God. Look at me.
Oh,
Alright, so I'd like to blow up their cover to increase my hit chance. But the game is being fucky. I really don't want to kill both of them. This looks like it'll work. If it kills both of them, oh well.
With pleasure.
Alright. Now y'all are exposed. I can run up and pistol one of them in the face. So that's exactly what I'm going to do. The lower their health, the easier it is it's going to be to stun them. And so it's better for me to just do this. Well, that's really unfortunate. Shit. I've never seen a pistol crit at 3. I really have never seen a pistol crit at 3. So that was completely unexpected for me. Alright, we're gonna go over here and hope we don't get poisoned. Alright, we're good. So now this motherfucker is trapped. We're gonna reload. I put this character on Overwatch, but I don't want them to kill the thin man. I definitely want to get this guy. Ah, motherfucker! It wouldn't have mattered anyways, they got strangled. Whoops! He fired this way and screwed over my cover. That's not good. Alright. So I can heal this character. That's what I'm gonna do. So that way he's not just dying of poison constantly.
Rub some dirt on it, you wimp.
There you go. Now, is this character within range to stun him? I think this one would be.
This is a disturbing sight, to say the least. It's hard to differentiate where the organic material ends and the machine begins.
Oh, you're fucking kidding me? That was a dash?
That's for sure.
What? That's a big fucking ripoff. That's not supposed to be a dash, jeez. Alright, well the good news is Spike is a sergeant. So I think we can trigger this Overwatch without worry. Oh, it doesn't even matter. Alright. I'm gonna toss a grenade over the train if I can. Actually, wait, hold up. We're forgetting someone!
Position confirmed.
Fuck! I think I can't see him. Are you serious? That's really annoying. I just want to capture the Thin Man. This is why it's really good to try and get the containment thing up by the end of the month. So at the very least, oh great, now there are sectoids. Because there's so many fucking things that can happen. Look at this shit. Oh great. He just killed my motherfucking...
X-ray coming in from the sides. Got me locked
down. Well, that sergeant was worthless. To see what happens. I really, 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 really... I'm super tempted to revert, first off. Because we're in a bad position where there's fucking, like, four guys flanking this character, and all I want to do is fucking capture this guy. And the only reason this went so bad is because I tried to move to a position that said it was going to let me flank. And yet it was a dashing action, which cancels out everything. But fuck it, I don't care, whatever. If we can get this thin man, it's all worth something. Ha! Half the sectoids weren't even activated yet. Jesus Christ. If I lose this fucking assault guy, I'm reverting all the way back.
Excellent. Now we can begin preparing for the interrogation.
God. I'm sorry, I have to do this. I want the sectoids, I want the floaters, and I want the thin men. I can't do that if I lost the only other fucking person who has an arc thrower. God damn it. Okay, we're gonna redo this. So, here's what happened. For some reason, I can go here. This is blue, but this is not. So, what ended up happening is I didn't see that it said dashing. That was my own fault. But usually, the way I tell I'm dashing is if I see the yellow outline, but the yellow outline goes out so far that I couldn't see that. So that was just really unfortunate. I could... Fuck, I hate this goddamn thin man. He's so far away. Well, I could throw a smoke grenade upwards to try and cover my character. That's not gonna work. Fuck it. Alright. We're just gonna shoot this stupid thing. Or you can miss! You can be completely fucking useless support character. That's okay as well. Anyways, I would have been totally fine with losing my assault character if it wasn't for the fact that this is literally the first mission I'm trying to arc throw people, and my arc thrower guy just fucking dies. And I want that. I want to try and capture these characters. I want the thin man's light plasma rifle, and I want the sectoid's plasma pistol. And getting a floater would be good as well, so I might as well do it in this first month, or this first day. Since I do have four things. But we're gonna play it safe because those floaters are really fucking annoying. I don't wanna like move my character up and then get screwed. So if he moves and dies, don't care. That's his own fault. Getting real fortunate. Okay. So we still need to heal this guy. I probably should have done that before. Oh my god! Are you fucking kidding me? How can you even see her? This should have blocked the I hate everything. I really want to blow up this fucking guy. Holy shit. Whatever.
Hey, quiet, you big baby. You're fine.
Fuck me. Everything's going bad. This stupid motherfucking strangler dude. We have floaters all over the front area. Ay-yi-yi. We're gonna go outside. She's far enough away that she can't be seen, hopefully. So we'll see what happens there. I don't want to run over here because that's gonna trigger both the floaters and the sectoids. We're in a bad spot. We're in a bad spot. I used my rocket to destroy cover to help me out, and look where that got me. Fuck it! We're moving up. Floaters will be floaters, say.
Scanning. Come get some.
Oh, hey, my cover's gone. That's not good. So, if I reposition correctly over here, I should be able to see every single enemy when they pop up. And so that'll allow me to take out a couple of them. I'm not afraid of killing the enemies. I just really, I really want to try and capture this thin man. With that said, there are other missions that I could do. that have plenty of thin men on them. So I could just take my losses and not get this guy. But we put so much fucking effort in trying to capture this motherfucker. The most annoying thing, the most fucking infuriating thing about trying to capture these aliens is the fact that they can go really far, really fast. And the only way you can catch up with them is by dashing and putting yourself right in front of them, which is infuriating. So maybe my Arcthor should go on a support that runs, rather than a medkit. We'll see. There is a thing that I can grab that allows me to have two items on a character, so I can get a medkit and the support thing, which would allow me, I mean, look how far she can go without triggering the dashing. Look how far she can go with the dashing. It's insane. But it's a good that we have her to heal. With that said, I'm gonna move her because she's in a really bad spot. Alright, I don't want to deal with this thin man along with the floaters. So I need to figure out what the hell I want to do here. Alright, you know what? I got it. Okay. We're gonna throw a smoke grenade over here to support this guy's advance. And we're going to... I don't want to move up, because I know the floaters are right here. We know that now. And we know the sectoids are also going to move up to this position as well. Okay. But fuck it.
This is a disturbing sight, to say the least. It's hard to differentiate where the organic material ends and the machine begins.
It's not going to win any beauty contests, that's for sure.
I am totally fine with trying the hardest I fucking can to kill these floaters.
Confirm. Closing on target position now.
Because they're big jerks. Oh, by the way, I'm floating directly above you! Whoa! Alright, so the thin man's up there. If I run and gun and then overwatch, that could put me in a good position to keep myself alive. So we're gonna do that.
Roger that.
I could also just fire on one of these guys. Ah, 32% chance, fuck it. And this fucking guy triggers it. Ooh, nice! Stop running, you fuckass! God damn it! Oh my god! He just keeps on fucking going. We just want to capture you. Look at that. He's not even in dashing range. The only way I'm going to get this fucker is if I flank him from like two different directions.
Good copy. Moving on target. Rock and roll.
Oh my god. Hi, floater! Good to see you! Apparently you're directly behind the... You're directly behind the thin man that I just couldn't see at all. Alright, we're gonna go overwatch. There's always a small chance that a floater will try to fucking do the thing where they fly above you and be dicks, but... Yeah, we'll see what happens there.
Moving out.
Use your sprint to your advantage, lady! Look how far you can go! God, I need to support Arc Thrower Specialist. Hey look, there are the sectoids! Hey look, there's a floater! Hey look, it went up. At least it's not shooting us. This thin man does not want to be captured!
I've got a visual.
Motherfuck! Now this guy seems to be in range... for capture. So that's good.
On my way.
So if I can lower this thing's health, we might be good. I don't want to do too much damage, though. So I'm going to need to do some pistol shots. Let's see what we can do with the support chick. Hold up. Let me see if she's being any kind of vulnerable position. Not entirely, and it's heavy cover, so I'm fine with moving up. Oh my god, of course it's a fucking reaction shot.
It's raining death over here.
I hate floaters, man. Fuck. Okay, good enough. Good enough. Now I can snipe one of these guys. Specifically, I can kill one of those sectoids. I can also try to kill the other floater. The floater is the biggest threat, but it's also a really nice grab. But the sectoids are a good grab too, because if I can get two plasma pistols, that saves me some cost. Tons of enemies have light plasma rifles, so I'm not worried about that entirely. Let's see what happens first. Okay. You're fucking kidding me! All this fucking work to get this motherfucker! Oh my god. Jesus Christ. It's such a hassle to do this arc thrower shit. Oh my god.
Moving to Overwatch.
Okay, someone's dying today. And it's either gonna be this fucking floater, or it's gonna be the other floater. I'm fine with the sectoids. Floaters are the bigger threat. So it's either you or you. You or you. He's the closest to my guys, which is a good and bad thing. It's a good thing because I don't have to worry about the range of my arc thrower as much, but it's a bad thing because he can easily get a flank and, like, crit shot somebody. But this guy's the farthest. Fuck him.
He's down.
And then we're gonna just stick ourselves in this corner. Little sectoids? I'm not worried about sectoids as much. They don't run as far. Which is why it would have been nice to capture them way earlier. Uh-oh. Shit. They took out my cover.
They got me flanked.
Hi, Thin Man. Alright, he did two movements. We're fine. Oh boy. So I can get within range to kill this, or to capture it. Which is great! Which is fantastic! The only problem is, he's gonna be literally in flanking position of three enemies. And if you thought that Thin Man was bad,
On the move.
I just over-evaluated the capabilities of my assault. He's not the one with reaction shot. Whoops!
Subduing target.
Excellent. Now we can begin preparing for the interrogation.
Alright, so that's one interrogation target. I could get within range to do another one, I think? Let's see what happens.
Moving.
Yes! Okay, that's not as bad then. Let me get a pistol shot off on this sectoid. Actually, let me see what happens. I'm gonna snipe the sectoid all the way in the back. Or try to, at least. Because I really don't want that flanking. I mean, with the amount of money we're gonna get, worst comes to worst, I can make my own damn plasma pistols rather than collect all of them. Okay. So now I need to just do some pistol damage. And we're gonna, it has a 0% chance to crit, so I'm not gonna worry about critting. I want this thing to have as low as health as possible, but it doesn't look like that's gonna be happening.
Location confirmed.
Fuck it! Alright! We save again! Alright, we can't save at the moment. Fuck it, stun. 70% chance! Please! Please! Please, God!
Subduing target.
Thank you.
Target disabled.
Ugh. Alright then, man. You're all on your fucking own. Let's see what you can do now.
Watch the flanks.
Wow, by heavy? Really? That's an interesting choice. Okay. We're gonna move her back. I don't want her to be that close. Okay, I need my two assaults to, like, dash the hell up here. In two different directions. So that way, even if he goes that way, I have an assault close. If he goes this way, I have an assault close. Let's fucking rumble, bitch. I don't care if he has the ability to flank one of my characters easily. And then we're just gonna heal. Although maybe I should save the heal for somebody else.
Moving.
I wish I had suppression. Oh well.
Let's do this.
I could have overwatched and that would have made him maybe not run. But we'll see. Look at him book it!
Watch the
oh my god, look how far he fucking goes! I hate thin men! He just literally reversed all the way back to the other side! What a shitlord!
Yes, sir!
Moving.
Okay, here's what we're gonna do. The problem is, I want to put all my characters in Overwatch to make this motherfucker stay in place. But the aliens never do what you want them to do, and so more than likely, I put three people on Overwatch, and the guy's gonna go, I should run. This is a bad situation. And then as soon as he runs, he gets killed, and the mission ends, and I'm like, well, great, I wasted all that time for nothing.
Aye, aye, Commander.
Lost Mel, did so many different things. Yeah, fuck that. Alright, we're just gonna hunker down with this guy. Shotgun boy, let's bring you up. Okay, that's a good sign. That's a fantastic sign. All right, finally. Get out of here. Oh, thank God.
Operational objectives complete.
Oh. Fucking A. Operation Bloody Thunder was definitely bloody. Fucking Spike just died immediately as soon as those floaters showed up. That was awful. All because I wanted to capture a couple of thin men. I think we got two thin men, one sectoid, and one floater. Which is a pretty good start. And once I get my South American bonuses, we actually can get quite a lot. We have so many people wounded. Oh boy. Let's see. Damn good ground would be good. And then what we got here? Ooh, lightning reflexes. All my assaults need lightning reflexes. Jeez. Did he really not get hurt? Nice.
I know it wasn't easy, but this could really be a turning point in our research. Not only can we interrogate the subject, but bringing an alien back alive provides us with a much better understanding of their physiology. Impressive work indeed. Preparations in the containment facility are well underway.
Oh boy. Okay. Things could have been...
We will be in touch, Commander.
Far worse. I could have been playing Iron Man and then just had to live with the fact that every single one of my characters was dead.
Troubles me. What do we risk with our own investigations into the melding of human and machine? Will we see a line in the sand and refuse to cross it? Or will we move forward, willing to sacrifice everything for the sake of total victory? I have to believe that is not our future. Provided, of course, that the alien's technology remains in the right hands.
We should begin interrogating the alien subject immediately. I'm confident we can safely house it within the containment facility, but I can't say for how long.
I'm gonna, like... I'm really tempted to... build a whole bunch of arc throwers and just give them to my entire squad. That would have made life so much easier with how many people we had on the field. Okay, so what are we doing at the moment? We were waiting for the workshop to finish. It's currently April 7th. So when the workshop is done, that'll be April 11th, and that'll give us enough time. That'll give us 19 days to build a satellite uplink. So we should start building a few satellites already, so that way we don't have to worry about that as much. So we're gonna build...
Our current satellite uplink facilities are at full capacity. We should build additional uplinks as soon as possible to allow for new satellite deployments.
I was gonna say four, but then I realized, nah. What are the chances that we're gonna get a satellite-related request? Okay, as we continued our research into the alien weapon fragments and the other materials recovered from the field, we've come to realize how the aliens managed to make these substances work in conjunction with one another. While reducing the size of these components is often a challenge in and of itself, we decided to focus our initial efforts on a weapon more suited to deployment in our interceptors. This cannon was designed to concentrate energy within a small target area, and should be capable of punching through the armored hulls of the alien craft. Yeah, but we'll be fine for a while. Shen seems confident that given the appropriate resources and testing facility, he can bring many of these concepts to life. Well, now we have the foundry available. The foundry is super important. But we're not gonna worry about that just yet. Alright, so we're saving these interrogations for later, because again, I can do them instantaneously once I have South America covered, and that's gonna be just a little bit of the month away. So let's accelerate forward a little bit.
Additional workshop online.
The new engineers arrived this morning, Commander. We're always glad to have more help down here.
Okay, so now I can make myself another uplink thing, but I'm gonna have to actually sell items. We're not gonna sell Seeker Rex because those can be pretty hard to come across. I will sell... I need 20, so I'll sell a little bit of alien alloys. And then a bit of Illyrium. Okay. Oh, I need power! Shoot! That's fine, we got one day. What is this particular facility? Oh, it's the laboratory. Yay, scientists! Is the power generator up? It's not. Ah!
Commander, the Council is requesting your attention. Secure transmission coming in now.
What do we got? The Council has been the Council has been monitoring unusual reports about a hijack attempt on an unauthorized French military convoy. Although the alleged perpetrators were human, our intel indicates the aliens may also have been in the area. If true, this raises a number of questions about the cargo being moved. We'll need a squad to investigate. Central should have our complete report momentarily. One scientist and one engineer. Ooh, 150 cash, though. That is definitely something I want. What do we have available for this mission? I know what this mission is. There's gonna be a lot of thin men on sectoids on it, so I definitely want to capture them as much as possible. So I'm gonna make a couple more arc throwers since we are gonna get more money from this mission anyways. So we're gonna do this. To submit. Now let's see what we can do. I like how you have to go to the situation room from the mission control sometimes. Launch.
We are confident that you will handle this matter with discretion.
Alright, so let me see who we have available. Our sniper is super wounded. Oh, because of the fucking strangler? Are you serious? That's annoying. Anyways, we're gonna throw on some arc throwers on everybody. So that way we have a whole lot of chances to try and capture people, rather than just only the assaults. And then in the future, once I have more armor available, I'll definitely have supports for arc throwing. But for now, you're medic dutying. Dutying, I don't think that's a word.
We have visual on the mission site, setting down.